Alright, let's see how we can make this history page work. So, the way that I want this to work is that whenever I click on any of these books, when I view the book, I want that book to be added to the history, right? So this is going to be the history of the viewed books. So if I view these first two books, they should be here inside of that array. So go to the index.page and find that history here. So here it is, history. And here I'm just going to add route first. So history. And now I'm going to go to the routing, and of course we need to add a route here. So again, history. And I'm going to use the same template here, but the controller of course is going to be different. It's going to be, the name of the controller is going to be the history controller. Now let's take that name and let's create that controller. So history controller.js, and I'm going to borrow one of these here, just paste it here. Again, we need to change the name. I'm going to add a title, again history, and I'm going to remove all of this. Now the next thing I'm going to do, actually let me check if this works now. So before we do that, actually let's add a class here so we can see when this page is active. So here again, history. All right, now if we reload the page and whenever I click on history, yep, we got that class active. The only problem is that title is wrong, most popular books. Let me shift reload it. Yeah, it works great. The next thing we need to do is to create a function which is going to run whenever we click on any of this book. Now we already have that function, so all we need now is to actually create another function which is going to take this book and add it to that array. And same as with the cart and the favorite book and the wish list, we are going to save that array inside of service. So over here, let's add here this dot history. History again, I'm going to be an empty array. All right, now we have history here in our bookstore. The next thing I'm going to do is to go to main controller, and I need to write this function here. Scope.addHistory is equal to a function which is will take the book object, and then it's going to go to the bookstore.history and then push that book there. Alright. And this function now is it's going to be run whenever you click on the book, and whenever we click on the book, this function is going to run, right? This is the function that sets the book route. So right below this, I'm going to run this function, add history. And now the last thing we need to do here is to take this history array, come to the history controller, and say here scope.books is equal to whatever is in here. Alright, now if we reload the page, whenever I click on any of the books, these books are going to be added to that array, and if we go to history, here they are, but for some reason we don't see them. Can't read properly length of undefined. Oh yeah, I need to pass a book here, and I didn't do that, so I need to go over here, sorry, pass a book. And now, again, let's go from the beginning, let's reload. Most recent, let's click on any of these books. We have two viewed books. If we go to history, we got those books here. If we go to most popular, let's view this book. Now, if we go to the history, we got it here. Great, everything is working as it should. Awesome. So we are slowly coming to an end, and we have, I think we have built here amazing, very cool application. And I hope you're enjoying this as I am. And yeah, I'll see you in the next video. So, see you there.